In this video, we're gonna learn how to create a PDF from a PowerPoint and retain all of our structure in the document. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump into the ring. All right, the most important thing we do for PowerPoint accessibility in terms of it converting over to a PDF appropriately is to ensure that all of our content is inserted using an accessible design theme. Now for me, I have set up a custom theme, but essentially what that means is if I select a new slide and I select layout, I am always building in the contents of the layout of my theme. If you add any additional insert elements, chances are they will not be carried over appropriately. Now, once we have determined that we have used an accessible design theme, we can go ahead and save to create a PDF. Let's first try the old-fashioned way, file save as. We're gonna do file save as. I'm going to choose a location on my computer, and then in the drop-down menu, I'm simply going to choose PDF. Now from here, we have a bunch of different options we can choose from. I'm going to make sure I have all selected in my range. We want to have document properties, document structure tags for accessibility, and then we wanna select okay. Once we're done, we can select the save button. It will then create a PDF for us, which I'm now going to open. And then I'm going to open up the tags panel. Then we notice that we have everything nested inside of a document tag, which is exactly what we want. And we have the contents of our slide properly nested inside of our slide deck. So in this example, we have everything nested inside of section tags, but the truth is that's okay. Because we used an accessible slide design theme, my titles are all coming through as H2. And in just a couple of cases, my reading order appears to be off, but my list items are coming through appropriately, and the reading order is matching what I had set from within the PowerPoint. It also automatically artifacts any header or footer content, so my images are automatically artifacted, and my slide information in the very bottom right corner are automatically artifacted. Let's go ahead and check out a different conversion technique. We're gonna select the Acrobat tab. Let's select Preferences, and basically we can choose what we want to have converted over to the PDF. Now, sometimes this is better than creating it from the file save as method, but let's go ahead and see what this does first. We're going to now create the PDF using the Acrobat option instead of the file save as option. And here's the document. Let's open up the tags panel. And interesting, we kind of have the same idea, but there appears to be an art tag nested inside of the section tag. But it does appear that the content came through just the same. Oh, however, I noticed something kind of interesting. My special formatting is not coming through my slides. How interesting. I'm going to open up that other one we did from the file save as. Interesting. And my sub content was actually coming through. So on slide 17, when we do the file save as method, it's carrying over my nested title. But when I do the Acrobat tab, it is not. I wonder if that means I have a setting that I need to set in the Preferences tab. But it does appear that our file save as method is the best method for maintaining the structure and integrity of your PowerPoint slide deck. Now, truthfully, over the years, the file save as method was not always the preferred way to create a PDF. There would often be times where it would mess up the font encoding, or it would sometimes put the elements out of the correct reading order. But as of recording this video here in July of 2025, that is when I am recording, the file save as method appears to be the best way to maintain proper formatting of your document when converting from Microsoft PowerPoint over to Adobe PDF. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.